So now we're on to this question with the loan repayment. So we are given a spreadsheet file which you will have to open up and fill in, and at the end print out what you've done. So it says we need to determine the monthly repayment amount and the final repayment amount. Loan amount of £15,000 over 48 months, monthly repayments, and an interest rate annually of 9.5%. So first thing to notice is it's monthly repayments, but we're given an annual monthly rate. So let's see how we do this. You'll fill in this box with the interest rate formula to convert to monthly interest. Now, if you forget how to do this, then you can use a simpler formula. You could say equals C8 divided by 12, although that would be wrong. It would allow you to do the rest of the question and get those marks. For your monthly repayment, you just guessed something. So I've guessed £400, but you could guess anything, as long as it's big, as long as that guess is big enough to pay off your loan. First, fill down the months to the number of months, and then you can fill in your formulae for the first month. As you can see, the first row zero is a little bit different because there's no repayment as soon as you take the loan out. Interest calculation should be done with the round function. So it's previous balance in blue, you can see F15, multiplied by an absolute cell reference to the monthly interest rate. Remember, absolute cell reference by pressing F4 or pressing FNF4. Or I suppose you could type in the dollar signs yourself. The interest, the capital content is the repayment take away the interest. So that's how much is left over after you've made the interest payment to pay off the loan. And then the new loan balance is the previous balance take away the capital content. So that, take away that. And I've shown here in formula view how the formulae look. Will I do that again? No, I won't. Highlight that row, double click green square, fill it down. Now we want to get the last cell to have a balance of zero. So we use goal seek, set that to zero, and by changing the cell, which is the monthly repayment there. This can take a few seconds to settle down, but once it's done, you go to your monthly repayment, and you see there you have all these extra decimal places, so we don't want those. So you have to manually round it. You can either round up or round down to the nearest penny. Now I like to round up, but apparently you can do it either way. Then you will see at the end you have a balance of minus 0.07, so you've paid off 7 pence too much. So it means that to fix this, you change your final repayment to be 7 pence smaller, just by typing in at the end there, minus 0.07. And it wanted us to have it in that cell as well, so remember to put it in there. And that should be that done. Now we are on to part B, where we have to fill in another spreadsheet. And this time it's for one of these finance options. Only for option 2, in fact. We don't need to do a spreadsheet for option 1. We are given the payments of £300 a month, and also an extra payment of £5,000 in the final month. So we start by guessing an interest rate. So I've just said 5%, but you could use any percentage. The monthly interest rate is the converted form of that, which is done with that formula. Fill in the second row of the table, absolute cell reference, the monthly repayment, interest repayment is done with round on the previous balance, and the capital content is the repayment take away the interest. That's how much is left over to pay off the loan. And new balance is previous balance take away the capital content. Now I'm showing you here all of the formulae which are needed. So now we are going to complete the repayment table. First, fill down the months to 48 months, and then we can highlight the second row of the table and then double click on the green square, and you see the cursor changes to a black cross. And we can also we also need to adjust the final payment, because there's this extra £5,000 which we can do by making a cell reference. You can see there final balance of -2,500. That's because we haven't got the correct interest rate, which we are going to find. So we do a goal seek again. This time it will be on the annual interest rate, and the monthly interest rate will update automatically. So we can see we found this solution of annual interest rate 11.05% and monthly interest rate of 0.88%. Now we're on to part C, where we need to state two reasons you might decide to use the bank loan instead of the finance options. In part B, we worked out an interest rate effectively of 11.05%. So it would make sense to compare this interest rate with the interest rate of 9.5%. We can see that the interest rate on the loan is lower, so that would be an advantage of the loan. So now we need to state a second reason. Now I personally find these questions a little bit difficult. We have to think of something. These two options are actually quite similar to each other. But in option one, they are not keeping the car at the end. Option two, they can keep the car at the end, but they have to pay this additional £5,000. So you could say the advantage of the bank loan is that she can keep the car at the end, and she doesn't have to find this £5,000, which is quite a lot of money to be finding in a single month. Okay, so she can keep the car and doesn't have to find £5,000 in one go. And remember, hand all your printing in at the end for these spreadsheet questions, because there is a history of printing just disappearing, which is really unfortunate if you've done it.